Hey guys, Dan with Kane Custom Garage here. Hey, today I want to fix this side cover for my 751. It's got a few cracks in it, and I don't have a way to weld aluminum, so we're gonna do some custom JB Weld fix here. See, there's a crack here, and then there's one here. So there's also a big chunk out here, so we're going to try and fix all that by clamping it and backing it up with some aluminum and some JB Weld. I've tried the aluminum soldering rods that they sell, and those are just a pain in the ass from what I've found. You got to try and get this as hot enough to melt the solder in there, and by the time you do that, it melts a big hole out of it and just turns it into a mess. So, and these are basically just cosmetic cracks. It's not really affecting the bar clamp or anything. So all I want to do is keep it from cracking more, because I want to keep the patina of this. I'm not going to paint this. So I want this saw to look old, just like it was. So what I got here is, I just cut up a piece of an old license plate, nice piece of aluminum there, and it's going to fit right here, and I'm going to clamp that with some JB Weld, and that should hold everything together and keep it from cracking more. So first thing I want to do is find the ends of these cracks and drill a tiny little hole there so that it doesn't keep cracking. It sort of stops the crack. So I'm gonna drill that one right there. And then this one goes all the way up to here. See, it's right there, there, there. So we're gonna drill that one. This one, there we go, that should stop the crack from going any further. And then up here there's a little crack, goes all the way down to here. Give that one a little drill. There. Yeah, they just didn't make the casting thick enough on these, and so yeah, it cracks really easy when they get dropped and thrown around out in the woods. And then the other thing I wanted to do was take the old Dremel tool and sort of scratch up in the crack there and sort of clean it all up really good, because that's what's going to help the JB Weld stick. The scratched and more rough the surface is, the better it'll stick. So let's do that. This thing's freaking loud, so I'm going to put on my earmuffs. Hopefully it's not too loud for you guys. Okay, so that's done. See how it sort of followed the cracks, opened them up a little bit. And then I'm going to take some of this 36 grit And then you just scratch it up really good. That way the JB Weld will stick real nice. And then our piece of license plate. Scratch up the back of that really well. That looks pretty good. Okay. Make sure that's all clean in there. Okay. So that piece is going to go like that. And then I also have this top cover that I want to do something with. Put some JB Weld in that. I got this big hole here. And then I'm going to try to fill this broken tab with JB Weld and then drill it out. Hopefully it'll be strong enough. Look at that. Where? How do you suppose that happened? Looks like they smacked it with a chain or something. Okay, so now what we're going to do is I'm going to tape the back of these big parts I need to fill, like right here. And that's about it on that one. And this one, I'm going to tape the back side of that hole. There. Now we got something to fill there. And this guy. We'll make a little dam here. Sort of like this. Something like that. Okay. Now we're gonna take our JB. Aw, man. This stuff's nasty and sticky. Okay. Oh. We're gonna mix up two equal parts. I'm gonna need quite a bit, so I'll just use up the rest of this one. So there's that guy. Where's the other one? Oh, here it is. This guy. Come on. Yeah, okay. And you mix them up really well. Make sure you get both parts equally mixed. Ew. This cardboard's not stiff enough. It's trying to fold over on me. It's working, it's working. Scrape it a few times, mix it, scrape it, mix it, scrape it. Okay. All right, so let's take, put some in here. Oh yeah, we gonna butter it on there. Get some in that crack. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to butter this other side. Man, I'm not going to have enough to do that other one. I'll have to mix up a little more. Yummy. Stuff smells weird too. Okay, now what are we gonna do? I didn't even do that. I will get this on there first. So this is gonna go like this. Nice. And then we're gonna clamp it. So I think the clamping, the pressure of the clamp sort of makes it stronger too. So we're gonna clamp that here. Here. Let's see what else we got. This one ought to work. Gonna clamp it here. Ooh. Done squished out. Sort of smooth out the edges a little bit. Gross. Oh, that's custom. Okay. So there's that. If I got enough left to do this crack and hole here, maybe let's blob it in there. Oh yeah, Okay, so there's that piece, all clamped together. Nice. I'm gonna stop it for a minute. I'm gonna mix up some more for this other piece, so I'll be right back. Okay guys, I'm back. I mixed up some more. So, let's fill this giant hole right here. Just do the old like that. Try to get it somewhat smooth so you don't have 10 tons of sand off. But sometimes you don't want it to be too tight either, because then you still have a big hole. So we're going to do just like, and sort of hit it in both directions so it sort of gets in to all the cracks. Okay, that's probably good. Now, where else did we have? We got that big hole there. Let's go like this. Let's see if we can squish that in there. Like this. Flip this up. We'll see if that gets a nice strong boss in there for us. I think that was really the only spot on that. Oh, and then I wanted to do, just in case you guys are wondering how strong this is, I'm gonna do a little experiment. And I'm gonna glue a couple pieces of this license plate together just to see how strong it is. Maybe this part here. And this part. Okay. On here. all about surface area. The more surface area you get, the stronger the bond. A little on this side, something like that. And then we'll just go like that. Put a clamp on it. Taking out those. Maybe. A little tighter. There. So we'll clamp those two pieces together and see what happens. So, the only thing I don't like about this JB Weld, the cold weld or whatever they call it, is it takes frickin' forever to set up, so we're gonna have to wait till tomorrow before it's done, so I'll see you then. Go do something else.
Oh yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe and watch part 2 of this video.